Okay, so real quick, I'm just gonna lay out the disclaimer that this video is from my objective point of view, and some of you all may find it very controversial. However, it's something that needs to be discussed. So let's talk about, has Wuthering Waves learned from its past mistakes? So if you're only interested in the short answer, then the answer is both yes and no. Okay, long answer time. So the reason I say yes and no is because they have been taking opinions from the community and been fixing major problems inside the game that have been needed to be addressed. The biggest example of this is going to be the English dub rewrite. I think I speak for most when I say the English dub in wuwa 1.0 was kinda ass. And the best example was none other than Yang Yang. The response to the overwhelming majority of players saying how much they hated the English dub was Kuro Games firing the director in charge of the dub and redoing the entire 1.0 story and improving the English dub from its original state, making it much more bearable. However, that's where the yes ends, well, sort of. You see, before we go into why they haven't learned from their mistakes, I think it's important to note that Kuro has been releasing hotfix after hotfix, bug fix after bug fix, they've been addressing problems that the game has had, and doing their best to improve the quality of life in the game. This ended up causing version 1.1 of the game to be released early, so that they could fix a lot of stuff, improve a few systems, etc, etc. However, this has inadvertently contributed to Wuthering Waves feeling almost dead, as this update has been extended as a result of this action, meaning we had a good week and a half to 2 weeks where the game did damn near nothing, and we had nothing to do. This, however, does have a light at the end of the dark, dark tunnel. That being, as the release of this video, Chingli will have been released along with another event to keep players entertained. And now we move on to the part where I address the elephant in the room and tell you how they haven't totally learned from their mistakes. Tell me, how satisfied is everyone with the waveplay to reward ratio in the game? You know, the same system that's been in place since launch? The same system that most people have been begging Kuro Games to change since pretty early on in the game's lifecycle. The best example of is the ecosystem, specifically the tacit fields. It's no exaggeration to say that the rewards you get from tacit fields are less than optimal. This is especially noticeable when you have a transition from Soul Phase 5 to Soul Phase 6, in which I noticed that the rewards that should have increased, barely being increased to the point of barely even being noticeable, if at all. So much so that I question whether or not I actually got more rewards from a higher difficulty. Obviously, I did get some extra rewards, however, the system as of now is still just as bad as it was in 1.0. If that's not enough to convince you, then let's also talk about the fact that more and more players are starting to notice when leveling characters from 70 to 80 that they aren't getting enough from the forge rate challenges, which are what you grind out to level your skills. So essentially, it's taking even longer to build units. Hell, I've been playing since practically minute 1 in the game, and I barely have a fully functioning team. Granted, I'm not max refreshing, but here's the thing. Most players aren't max refreshing since most players are free to play in this game, meaning that the majority of the player base is going to have maybe 2, but typically just 1 team fully built, and that's if you're lucky. Not to mention that even some whales I'm friends with don't think that max refreshing is even worth it, and they spend hundreds to thousands of dollars on the game. In the past, I addressed it in another video, but I'm just going to mention it here. That in my opinion, the best way to make it more player-friendly is to increase the waveplay-to-rewards ratio, universally that is, by at least a minimum of 1.5 times its current drop rate to maybe 2 times its current drop rate. This still keeps the grind that some players desire from their games, and still keeps the longevity of the game going. Okay, now let's talk about Echoes one more time. We've addressed that we don't have enough experience from tacit fields and other sources. However, what about all those useless Echoes you have just sitting in your inventory collecting dust? Well, for the low, low price of 5 Echoes, you too can get gangbanged by the system and given one shitty Echo back in return. Okay, that was an exaggeration on my part, but you can hardly blame me when the system feels so absolutely useless as it is now. I don't think it'd be a problem if they let you convert your 5-star Echoes that are just sitting there into, at the very least, mid-low tier experience for leveling up Echoes. Well, that's gonna do it for this video, guys. This video is honestly just made to kind of be informational and give my honest thoughts, and maybe, just maybe, someone at Kuro Games or a bigger content creator might see this and spread it, so the Kuro Games will finally fix the biggest issue the game has. With that, everyone, if you liked the video, please drop a like and subscribe, and hit that notification bell. I stream most days over at twitch.tv/mimicsoul, so be sure to go check me out over there and give me a follow. With that, everyone, take care, have a great rest of your day, and I'll catch you all in the next video.